Good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome our seniors, their parents, families, EDS students, faculty and staff, members of the Board of Trustees and other friends to Evansville Day School's 60th annual commencement ceremony here at the Shanklin Theater on the beautiful campus of the University of Evansville. It's appropriate to be on a college campus as we acknowledge the transition that we are part of during this ceremony. My name is Kevin Kunst, head of school, and it is an honor to be here with you tonight to celebrate the exceptional young people that make up the EDS class of 2024. Let me begin by thanking the parents, grandparents, and family members of these graduates. I have no doubt you have sacrificed of yourselves to support these young men and women, and I assure you your investment of time, treasure, and love has paid off and will continue to as these seniors go out and do incredible things in the world. Thank you so much for your commitment to them and for sharing them with us as they have grown into these gifted and talented young adults. In addition, I'd like to recognize the dedicated faculty and staff of Evansville Day School, who every day demonstrate an integrity of purpose and a joy for their work. This class makes up 14 of the many students that represent the fruits of your labor, the why of who you are and what you do. Thank you so much for your commitment to them and all the students who step foot on campus. Our faculty and staff are seated over here on stage left. I would love it if we could give them a round of applause for all that they do. The class of 2024 is full of possibilities. Future lawyers, future teachers, future architects, future engineers, future coders, future titans of industry. They will fill all of these roles and will likely create new ones as they face an ever-evolving world, prepared and ready. They began their high school careers masked and unsure of what the future would hold. Perhaps the most difficult transition any freshman class has ever had to face. But we learned quickly that this class is not a class to be deterred. We believe in and preach resilience as part of our portrait of a graduate, but they go beyond that. They're tenacious. They don't just survive adversity, they attack it, wrestle with it, and conquer it. This class is ambitious and yet unbelievably grounded. They have provided 4 years of excellent leadership in our SLC. They have ushered in new traditions, and they have set an incredible academic standard. This class of 14 students has sat for 109 AP exams, 29 in classes that I taught. But what I love about them is that they understand the idea of day school as a family. Some of them because literally their family has worked at the school, but they are always thinking about the whole, joining teams to support their friends, mentoring and working with younger students, building relationships with teachers that will last a lifetime. They do family really well. To the class of 2024, please never lose that quality. Be a support to one another and to those around you. Take out into the world this belief in service that you hold and understand so deeply, that you have consistently invested in, and you teach others through your example. The world needs this right now. The world needs you. And though I am not sure the world is ready for you quite yet, I have no doubt in my mind that you are ready for it. You have lived out our mission to its fullest. And as you have striven for excellence in mind, body, and human spirit, and on behalf of everyone, I want to thank you for that. And with that, we will begin the awards presentation of the evening with the Larry Doc Grimes Hart Award, which is a faculty and staff award, presented this evening by Patrick Jackson, EDS class of 1980.
Good evening. My name is Patrick Jackson. 44 years ago, almost to the day, my 21 classmates and I, like these young men and women, were in this building, seated on this very stage, to receive our diplomas from Evansville Day School. By now, your mental calculators are telling you, wow, this guy is just a few birthdays short of a fossil. Seriously, in my wildest imaginings, I never considered that I would ever be back here again participating in another day school commencement exercise. But here I am, and I'm grateful for the opportunity. The Larry Dot Grimes Hart Award is presented annually to a faculty member selected by an alumni panel based upon community recommendations. Larry Dot Grimes taught at EDS from 1976 to 1983. During his tenure, he taught middle and upper school social studies, yearbook, and as well coached tennis and basketball. More than that, he inspired those around him, particularly his students. One of his most outstanding qualities was the way he truly cared about the well-being of his students, not just while they were in his classroom, but outside of it. His gentle spirit, kindness, and big heart left a legacy, impacting lives beyond his own. On a personal note, I knew Doc. He began his teaching career during my freshman year. He was a good teacher, a leader, a mentor, and a kind and generous human being. Those of us who knew him well miss him. To celebrate this legacy, members of the Alumni Association have established an endowment to annually award $1,000 to a teacher nominated for the Larry Grimes Hart Award, who demonstrates going the extra mile for students beyond the classroom. This year's recipient certainly is a modern version of Doc in that she does it all, coaching, teaching, and supporting students in all aspects of their EDS experience. One parent wrote, "She has excelled at every aspect that day school has thrown at her. She exemplifies all that this award is designed to showcase." Her students share their thoughts as well. One student wrote, "She has always been there for her students by showing up to our sporting events, even on the road when no one asks. She is always involved in all the sporting events and extracurricular activities and events. I can't remember the last event I went to that she did not take part in planning and attending." Another student shared, "She brings light to everyone's day and has always been there for students, even when they don't ask her to be. She has always been there for me to congratulate me on my achievements and celebrate my highs, and has continuously been there to pick me up from my lows." Independent schools are fueled by individuals that step up when asked. And this year's recipient has consistently done that. From teaching in the primary school to teaching with and agreeing to be co-director of Summer Academy, to running the iLab for a short time, to being the school's inaugural director of student life, and now agreeing to follow Tom Dragon as the new director of athletics, she says yes, a lot. She even agreed, like Doc, to take over the yearbook when asked a few years ago. She is truly an Eagle through and through. I am pleased to present this year's Larry Dot Grimes Hart Award to Mrs. Sarah Brooks. Now, seniors, you have heard about the leadership of Larry Grimes and witnessed the leadership of Mrs. Brooks. As you leave here tonight, consider their example. Be good at what you do. Be a leader. Be a mentor. be kind, and most importantly, do your part to leave the world a better place than you found it. Congratulations to all of you. Congratulations to Mrs. Brooks.
Good evening, I'm Marcus Hester, and I'm proud to present this year's Alumni Awards. The Evansville Day School Alumni Award is given to the senior or seniors who best exemplify school spirit, demonstrate dedication to EDS, are advocates of EDS, and who are likely to contribute to the longevity of the school. This evening, I'm proud to announce we have two recipients of this award. Our first recipient started at EDS as a relatively quiet seventh grader. By performing as Ed the Eagle, EDS beloved mascot, she began to gain more and more confidence in her ability to perform. She eventually took center stage in the school's musical productions, belting out songs with confidence and ease. This student has displayed leadership skills as part of the Student Leadership Council and has been a consistent cheerleader for SLC events. Not only is she a leader amongst her peers, but she has also participated in the recruitment of new families by being a spokesperson for the arts at preview nights and welcome events. It's my honor to present the first Alumni Award this evening to Trista Browning. Our second recipient of the Evansville Day School Alumni Award has had a similar path from his first day as a new seventh grader to his presence, which you'll see on the stage tonight. His contributions to EDS have been consistent and quite impressive. He has shown enthusiasm and dedication to soccer, basketball, track, performing arts, and more importantly, the classroom. He speaks openly about his desire to build community. His work in the Student Leadership Council and as a team leader has made that desire apparent. He also has never hesitated to communicate his love for EDS to new families and students. It's my honor to present the second Alumni Award this evening to Jesse Kuntz. Both Trista and Jesse display the portrait of an EDS graduate and have shown their dedication to EDS time and time again. We strongly believe they are perfect recipients for this year's Alumni Award. Again, please join me in congratulating this year's 2024 Alumni Award recipients, Trista Browning and Jesse Kuntz.
I'm Sarah Brooks, and I work as the Director of Student Life. This role allows me the unique opportunity to work with and provide events for all of our students. It is because of this that I get the honor of presenting our Lifer Award. While we love and celebrate all of our students, there's something special about the success of a Lifer. Since day school begins educating children as young as three, the EDS staff feels that our Lifers quite literally grow up in front of us, with so much of their lives being spent within the walls of our school. If we just consider the school day, these students have spent at least 20,250 hours at school during their time at EDS. However, those hours don't consider any of the extras that this year's lifers were involved with, which have included the following: before care, after care, POMS practice, robotics club, soccer, musical rehearsals, cheer practices, venture club, basketball practice, track practices, fine arts nights, golf practices, tennis, running club, homecomings, movie premiere nights, winter formals, fright nights, gnome nights, and so much more I'm sure I have overlooked. While we've watched some staff and students leave, they have also been so much a part of the welcoming of people to the EDS family. They have served as a constant amidst change and kept the family ideal alive. Most notably, these specific seniors have been a huge part of engaging in the integration of our house system. They have helped create a special bond with their younger housemates and even encouraged the next generations of lifers within it. On behalf of every staff member that is or has been a part of day school during your time, I want to say congratulations to these wonderful humans. We have enjoyed watching you grow up within the walls of our school. We appreciate all that you have done to remind us what it has meant to be a part of the EDS family. The enthusiasm you have brought to things that you do and all of the ways that you have uniquely added to what EDS is, community as a whole, has been important to us. Before I finish, I'll ask what I asked last year. I would like you to remember one thing. We mean it when we say, once an Eagle, always an Eagle. So I expect to see you back on campus for years to come. It's my honor to award the Lifer Award to Rosemary Alcock, Zane D'Amizio, Nathan Foster, and Nate Phillips. Congratulations.
Most we did, and why I just don't. Good evening. My name is, Good evening. My name is Mackenzie Gelhausen. There we go. I'm the Director of College Counseling, and I will be giving out the Senior Project Award. Each senior at EDS is required to participate in what we call senior projects. Senior projects consist of a week-long internship with someone in a field of the student's interest and a presentation about their experience. These senior projects give our students valuable real-world experience as they get firsthand knowledge about a career that interests them. These seniors presented their senior projects in the atrium yesterday to an audience of their teachers, peers, and families. Internships this year ranged from working at the Evansville Courier Press and witnessing Election Day firsthand, to working at Tri-State Orthopedics and observing a knee replacement, to working at USI's technology department and seeing the inside logistics of running a campus's tech infrastructure. I am so proud of the hard work that all of our seniors put into this year's senior projects. Before I officially announce the winner of this year's award, let me tell you a little bit about what they did for their senior project. This student completed their internship at the University of Evansville, the Evansville Regional Sports Commission, and the Evansville Regional Economic Partnership, where they were able to see a variety of aspects of marketing and event planning. This student spent their first day at the EREP golf outing, where they learned about how big events are planned and how you must pivot when faced with a problem. The second day was spent at a UE baseball game where they got to see the behind the scenes of just how much goes into making game day happen. Next, we all learned about the Belong Here program and the E is for Everyone campaign from this student. And finally, this student taught us about the event planning process from the brainstorming phase to the execution phase. This student made their project engaging and interesting and even got the audience involved with an interactive poll where we all collectively decided that our favorite pizza in Evansville was either Pangea or Azip. Personally, I voted Pangea. Things even got competitive when volunteers from the audience were asked to come up in front and create their best version of a marketable E in relation to the E for Everyone campaign. This student took their project seriously and made a tremendous effort to make their presentation not only informative, but entertaining as well. They really put those marketing skills they learned during their internship into action during their project. I think that this student is a perfect example of what a day school student is: motivated, intelligent, poised, and just an all-around amazing human being. This student's hard work certainly did not go unnoticed, and I am extremely proud to present this year's Senior Project Award to Katrina Braun.
Each year, Evansville Day School recognizes an outstanding faculty member as the Salt and Light Award recipient here at our commencement ceremony. In honor of Mrs. Helen Betcher, a beloved teacher who loved day school and was known to be the salt of the earth and the light of knowledge for her students and an inspiration for her peers in the school community, this award is made possible through a generous contribution placed in an endowment. The award is chosen by the head of school in collaboration with the administrative team based on criteria most memorable about Helen. In our portrait of a graduate, perhaps the most undefined of the virtues is balance. Depending on the individual, what makes up balance might be a very unique thing. I think one of the ways it manifests itself is in an appreciation of the beauty and life that is all around us, an ability to pause sometimes, be silent sometimes, and free our minds sometimes in order to see all of what can be seen. The recipient of this year's Salt and Light Award is one of the teachers who most readily invites our students to find balance and what it means for them. And he is certainly one who helps us see beauty. Pablo Picasso once wrote, "Art washes away from the soul the dust of everyday life." Whether it is through a firm brushstroke, a nuanced blending of color, or even painstakingly tearing up little bits of paper, his students are given the tools to touch the soul. And he himself is an artist in every sense of the word. An avid baker, he shares his love of that craft with our students in feeding them, but also in teaching them how to feed others, how to blend together disparate ingredients to create a food that will bring joy. He is a constant presence in the hallways, greeting and guiding our students as they move between classes, literally and metaphorically, keeping them on the path forward. And he loves people. He invests in them and engages with them in a way that allows all around him to feel loved, respected, and seen. I have known a lot of artists. I am married to an artist. And I have worked with a lot of artists. They tend to be very creative, and with that creativity comes a wonderful messiness. I have never known one who keeps their space as meticulous as he does. I have on tours remarked that I am fairly confident one could safely perform surgery in his art room. And that leads to another incredible trait he has, and that he passes on to our students a discipline in what one does. And in some ways, it is that, this blend of discipline and creativity, logic and beauty, that makes him special and makes him such a strong leader in our effort to teach balance. It is my great privilege, and on behalf of Evansville Day School, to present the Helen Betcher Salt and Light Award to Mr. Clinton Bosler.
Good evening. My name's Holly Ziemer, and I'm the assistant head of school and head of upper school. And I'm pleased to present this year's Humanist Award. Humanists affirm the ability and responsibility to lead ethical lives of personal fulfillment that aspire to the greater good. With her tireless efforts supporting the Community Service Committee of the Student Leadership Council, Maddie Wintner has modeled the characteristics of a humanist servant leader and has improved the lives of countless people in our school and broader communities. Some of Maddie's notable humanitarian work includes organizing the annual school-wide canned food drive for the benefit of Tri-State Food Bank for the last 4 years. Thousands of non-perishable food items have been supplied to those in need. In her freshman year, Maddie orchestrated an Earth Day cleanup that has continued and expanded in scope to include our important community partner and EDS neighbor, Wesselman Woods. Maddie also instituted a holiday adopt-a-family drive, bringing needed supplies and gifts to area families. And the school's Valentine's Day Grams, a much anticipated winter activity, is highly popular among students and also serves to give back to our community. Maddie's commitment to service is apparent in Maddie's classroom and co-curricular activities as well. She co-taught a Shakespeare seminar with Mr. Almohandro, led and organized the EDS newspaper, participated in varsity soccer and cheer, and shone in her stage career at EDS, winning this year's Drama Award. Maddie is now set to showcase her passion for service at Ball State University, where she will be majoring in education. Folks, let me tell you that Maddie's passion and commitment to entering the field of secondary English education is perhaps the biggest commitment to humanism that one could embody. Maddie spent last week shadowing middle school English teachers at North Junior High School, and the first takeaway that Maddie referenced in her senior project presentation Wednesday was that, quote, teachers don't do it for the money. They really enjoy the environment they are in and the students that they teach. Maddie concluded by noting that her senior project confirmed for her that teaching English is the correct career path. And Maddie already put Mr. Almohandro on notice that she's coming to take his job in just 4 years from now. Any school would be incredibly fortunate to have Maddie on its staff. And so it's my honor to now present the 2024 Humanist Award, given for distinguished service, consistent concern for others, and exceptional contributions to the school community, to Maddie Wintner.
The Head of School Award is presented to a senior who the upper school faculty feel has contributed greatly to the life of EDS by virtue of his or her strength of character, qualities of leadership, and participation in school activities. The great Olympian distance runner, Mo Farah, once said, "Don't dream of winning, train for it." The recipient of this award has a runner's focus and a determination that extends to all that she does. And she has been a great example to all of our students of one of our key Portrait of the Graduate virtues, resilience. She has been a significant contributor to our Student Leadership Council, spending 2 years in a leadership role with the Co-Curricular Committee and then serving this past year as one of the team leaders of the SLC. She is a member of both the National Honor Society and the Global Language National Honor Society. She has an interest in journalism and marketing, and she has worked to keep an upper school newspaper afloat, while also managing upper school social media and working as a marketing intern during her junior year. She's an AP scholar and earned her AP capstone diploma. She was a Vandenberg County finalist for the prestigious Lilly Endowment Scholarship, and she received a nomination from Senator Todd Young to the Service Academies. Athletically, she's an avid runner, a staple of our cross-country and track teams, and captain and a leader. She has over the years contributed to many teams as needed, including an MVP season and leadership role with our cheer squad. She was the Kiwanis Club Mental Attitude Award winner this year for both of her running seasons. And over the past 2 years, she has orchestrated a spring running club for the primary school, even earning recognition from Under Armour for her efforts. Outside of school, she has spent time as a member of the Indiana Legislative Youth Advisory Council and volunteered at both the Ronald McDonald House and with the Evansville Sports Corporation. And those are just the highlights of her resume. Beyond the service and accomplishments, there is a person. Albeit at times fueled by a mildly disturbing Starbucks addiction, she is one of the most driven students I have ever known. She has a fierce determination to set goals and achieve them. I had the opportunity to have her in my AP Economics class, and in that class, we learned about behavioral economics and the theory by Daniel Kahneman and others that individuals don't always make the rational decision that most benefits them. The recipient of this award lives that out, consistently and humbly sacrificing of herself for a greater cause, her peers around her, and the corporate success of our school community. She is a servant leader in every sense of the word. And one of the ways she shows this is with the smile she has for everyone in the community and the care she feels in all of her interactions. She dreams of winning for herself and for others, and she works tirelessly to achieve those dreams. It is my great pleasure and honor to present the Head of School Award for the Class of 2024 to Megan Ryswick.
At this time, we'll invite our seniors, soon to be graduates, to the podium to deliver speeches.
Good evening. As many of you know, my name is Rosemary Alcock, and I'm going to Indiana University in the fall to study early childhood education. I have attended Evansville Day School since I was 3 years old, although I like to say I've been here since the day I was born because my older siblings were students here before me. With that being said, the first graduation I attended was for my oldest brother, and I was finishing up second grade. I remember while we were in the car on the way to my brother's graduation, my dad said, "The train has started and it won't be stopping anytime soon." This has stuck with me as I watched my 8 older siblings graduate, and now it's already my turn. I thought it would be forever until I was up on this stage. I was so excited to grow up and be a senior, but now that I'm here, knowing that saying goodbye is going to be so hard, I shouldn't have wished it away so soon. The last day of school used to be my highlight, knowing I would see everyone the same time next year, the same friends, the same teachers at the same place. But now our time has come. It is time to follow our dreams, as high school is now just a memory. As I reflect on my time here at EDS, there are many people that have helped shape me into the person I am today. I want to start off by thanking all of the amazing teachers I have had throughout my 15 years at EDS. I don't think you guys understand how much you taught me inside and outside of the classroom. I also want to thank my class for never failing to bring a smile to my face when I really needed it the most. I want to thank my coaches, Sarah Brooks, Tia Rogers, and Coach Dragon for never giving up on me. You taught me that true dedication really does pay off. I want to thank Laura D'Alto for always being there for me and allowing me to find my voice. I really didn't think I was going to cry. I want to thank all my friends for keeping me going throughout my high school years. I love you all. I also want to thank the whole Overby family for being like a second family to me. I'm so thankful for you guys. Lily, I can't wait to watch you grow up into a beautiful girl. Max, thank you for all the belly laughs and for always being so real. Cece, I don't know how to thank you enough. You're the most genuine soul I've ever met. Thank you for being my best friend. I love you. I love you all so much. I also would like to thank all of my older siblings for being the best role models I could ask for. I've always looked up to each and every one of you guys. Cecilia, thank you for being goofy with me. I have never laughed more than when I'm with you. Isabella, you have taught me so much in life. Your authenticity never ceases to amaze me. Sabina, thank you for being my other half. You are so beautiful inside and out. You are the one person that understands me more than anyone. I love you all more than words can describe. Next, I would like to thank my mom and dad. You guys have been parents at EDS for 24 years. Let's all give them a round of applause. Dad, you are the hardest working person I know. I strive to be more like you every day. Thank you for always being so honest with everything you say. Mom, thanks for always showing up for me. You have been my biggest supporter throughout my whole life, and I'll forever be grateful for that. I love you both so much. Thank you for everything. Laura and Ben, I don't think I tell you guys enough how grateful I am that you both came into my life when you did. I love you. If it weren't for each and every one of you, I would not be standing here on this stage, ready to write a new chapter of my life. Knowing that I will be continuing my journey at Indiana University makes little Rosemary so excited because ever since I was a little girl, my family went to IU games very often. As I'm preparing to fulfill those dreams, before I leave, I want to remind you all to live in the moment and really soak it all in. Because life is short and nothing lasts forever. Before you know it, it'll all just become a memory. Alcox out. Thank you.
As I stand before you all today, I can proudly say that I went to high school. It's already pretty late, so I'm gonna make this quick. When I realized I had to write a speech for graduation, I really didn't know what to say because there was so much to cover. Along with this, I couldn't ask Trista what she wrote about like every other essay I've written. This really affected my approach to this whole ordeal. Originally, I wanted to do a stand-up or some magic, but they told me no. So, I'm right here. I still don't really know what I'm supposed to say, but that's more because I know everyone else will cover that. They'll say some things we can laugh and cry at, so that'll be fun. But it means more or less, for me to talk about. It's also come to my attention that I have to thank people, because that's what you do. So first, I want to thank my parents for being my parents. They've been extremely supportive and helpful throughout everything I've been through, and it's been a lot. Next, I would like to thank Mr. O, who agreed to take a photo with me after this, which is big. He's a great teacher and an even cooler guy. Mr. Greenwell has also been very important to me for the hour and a half I spent in his class every week. Miss Englebright also deserves a special thank you for not giving me late passes every time, because I'm not sure I would be up here without her. Mr. Kunst gave me a ride home one time. So funny. Was it? Okay. More than one ride. Mr. Bowser's pretty cool too. And to the class of 2024, we did it. It only took 4 years, but we all made it, and I'm so proud of all of you. I can't wait to see what you all do this summer, and I can't wait to see some of you next fall. If you see me, be ready to meet the new Austin, because I plan on completely changing my personality. It's hard to believe that it's all coming to an end, but I'm so thankful for every one of the teachers and students and the family and friends that have helped me get here. As I close out this speech, I would like to leave you with one final thought. One time, Mr. Ward told me, "Fake it till you make it," and I am living proof. Thank you.
Hello, if you don't don't know me, I am Katrina, and I've been at EDS for 6 years now. I'm truly grateful for this school and all the opportunities and experiences that it has given me. From cheering at Gainbridge Fieldhouse with Rosie in 8th grade, to doing Gina Wilson worksheets in Mrs. Meyer's math class, to being Mrs. Rogers' 2nd grade teacher's assistant, EDS has filled my life with so many memories. I'm going to try and keep this short and sweet because the more I talk, the more I will cry, so I'm going to start by giving some thank yous. Mom and Dad, thank you for everything that you have done for me. Looking back, sending me to EDS was one of the best choices you could have made, as it has allowed me to become a more well-rounded person. You have supported me through everything, whether it was taking me to every cheer clinic possible or staying up late to help me with a last-minute project. You pushed me to become the best version of myself and to not be afraid to try new things. I am truly grateful for you both and for everything that you have provided for me. I love you guys. Alana, thank you for setting an example of what not to do. Just kidding. Growing up, we never really got along, but I'm glad we got past that because now I have you as a best friend. Sorry, guys. Thank you for always listening to me, for keeping my secrets, and for being the best big sister I could ask for. I'll miss you a lot, but I know you're going to do big things for the Pacers in Indianapolis. And I'll have to visit you because you're taking my cat with you. Grandma and Steve, thank you for loving me and supporting me with everything that I do. Grandma, you've taught me that kindness matters, and I'm so fortunate to have you to look up to. Thank you both for all the trips you've taken Alana and I on, and for always being there. The Myers family, thank you for welcoming me into your family like one of your own, even though I would say a total of 3 sentences at the beginning. I am thankful to have you all as my second family. Tyler, I've never met someone as selfless, caring, and hardworking as you. For the past 4 years, you have brought so much happiness and love to my life, and I still don't understand how lucky I am to have you. I'll forever be your biggest cheerleader, and I'll try not to annoy you too much at UE. I love you. Sarah and Tia, or Cheer Mom and Dad, thank you for being 2 of the most caring and supportive coaches. You have always encouraged me to reach for the stars and that nothing is impossible. I will forever be grateful for the 5 years that I had with you, and my offer still stands to hire me as an assistant cheer coach. Lastly, a thank you to the rest of my family here tonight, as well as all of the teachers and classmates at EDS who have helped me shape into who I am today. With that being said, I want to end my speech with a quote from Khloe Kardashian. It's been magical, but I'm done.
I'm Trista. You know who I am, I would hope. So good evening.
Good evening.
Let's try that again. Good evening.
Good evening!
Thank you so much. Thank you all for being here tonight. I really appreciate it. I started writing the speech 2 days ago, and I had no idea what to write. So here's what I come up with. Best intro. Right? All the years that you are in school, you think about your graduation year, and you never expect that it's really going to happen. When I was in kindergarten, 2024 didn't even seem like a real year. Though it was kindergarten, a lot of stuff didn't seem real. But somehow I stuck it out and ended up in one of these weird cap things that keeps tickling my face. But now it's finally here, and high school is over. Thank you guys so much for being the best friends and classmates I could ever ask for. Maddie and Megan, I've known you both for what feels like forever. Megan, I will never forget our undefeated basketball career in 6th grade. I will also never forget our exclusively defeated season in 8th grade. Thank you to Steve for leading us fearlessly. Maddie, even though you left my house one time when we were 7 because I didn't want to play La La Loopsies anymore, I'm glad that we stayed by each other's sides once you got over my bossiness. And Austin, you make every day interesting. If you've been in class with us, you understand what I'm talking about. To the teachers that have been blessed with having me and Austin in the same class, I am so sorry. I'm looking at you, Mr. Ward. I mean it. Okay. This year was my favorite school year to date. I did some very bad top golfing down in Louisville on our senior trip. We had an amazing musical. Miss D'Anto, you rock, by the way. And I laughed as hard as I could during my mega study hall with Rosie, Austin, and Berkeley. Don't worry, Ms. Zemer, we finished our work first. So let's run through some more thank yous. Thank you, Mr. O, for making me feel smart when we went over Shakespeare in class. I really enjoyed listening to your stories about Doug Barry. And I love our chats. Mr. Bosler, I have so many things to thank you for, I can't include them all in this speech. But thank you for inspiring me, for listening, and for being a bomb art teacher. Thank you to John Parker, Mindy Sages, Lyra Sages, and Berkeley Sages. Your house feels like home. I love you guys so much. You motivate me and inspire me every single day. Thank you, Berkeley, for inspiring me to pursue the things that I love and building me up whenever I need it. Thank you to my amazing family, those two rows right there. Mom, you've made me do every sport and every activity so that I could figure out what I really wanted to do. Dad, you helped me chill out when I was freaking out about anything and everything that Mom was making me do. I love you guys so much. And then to all of my current and future step-parents, thank you for always being there. Y'all are great. I love y'all so much. And then, although I'm sad that this chapter of my life is coming to a close, I couldn't be more grateful of everything you all have taught me. We're all about to, as my mom likes to say, right before I leave for school every single day, go conquer the world, and I'm so excited. I've made some amazing memories with everyone. And one more thing before I go. To all of my classmates behind me, don't forget to open those letters that Ms. Meyer told us. Do not open until high school graduation, May 2024. I have to revise what I wrote in the script because it's sitting in my car. So it better be good. The pressure has been on and building for 4 years. And I reckon that a good speech ends with a good quote. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Dr. Seuss, oh, the places you'll go. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ethan Foster. I have spent about the last 15 years of my life at Evansville Day School. So for many, this may feel like a funeral, considering how what has been my life for the past 15 years is ending. However, I see this as the beginning of the next chapter of my life. Evansville Day School has raised me like a part of their family. They taught me almost everything I know, from you get what you get and you don't throw a fit, to the golden rule, to what it means to be a leader, or how to discover one's self-personification. No school can offer the experience that Evansville Day School gave me. I have known some of these people since I was about 3 years old. Our class is like a family, or was a family. Although challenging, it is time for me to accept my departure from Evansville Day School, as if I were an eagle leaving its nest to spread its wings and explore the world. I want to thank my classmates for being themselves and making day school a home for me. I want to thank my teachers, from JPK to high school, for helping me become who I am today. I want to thank Ms. Luttrell and Ms. McCandless. You were patient while I was little and helped me build a solid foundation for learning. Ms. Powell taught me my love for science. I mean, hey, how many grade school kids actually get to hatch eggs? You had us explore the world around us and always encouraged our curiosity. Ms. Myers, our middle school math teacher, what can I say? I'm going into engineering at Purdue, which says thanks for giving me a love of math and helping me excel. In the high school, so many teachers to thank. From Ms. Moran, my science teacher, I was honored to help her teach chemistry sophomores this year. To Ms. Jennings, who had always had a kind word and a warm smile. To Mr. Omohundro, and all of our discussions about life and literature, and Mr. Bosler, who was so much fun exploring Japan during my junior intercession. To Ms. D'Alto, you helped me gain confidence in myself as a person and a speaker, and your advice will live in my mind for decades. and of course, Dr. Gibson. You were always concerned about each of us, ensuring our social and emotional well-being was watched out for. You all have taught me that nothing in this world is more potent than knowledge, and knowledge used for good. I want to thank my brothers for sticking with me and our family. We've had our ups and downs like most families, and if you guys don't know my family, I am one of the five boys, but specifically, I'm smack dab in the middle of brother number three. I want to thank my oldest brother, William, for not killing me and Andrew 13 years ago when we snuck into your room and broke one of your Lego sets. William, congratulations on your college graduation early this week. You have set the bar high, and you've always been a fantastic role model. I want to thank Brandon for always being there for me when I needed you and treating me as an equal despite your higher intellect, Notre Dame. If you do not know Brandon, I would describe him as a 6'5", redheaded walking Wikipedia. Yeah. He knows so much about everything, and his mind feels like a steel trap. Brandon, you never spoke down to me and always had so much patience. For that, I'll be forever grateful. Andrew and Samuel, as the youngest of the family, thanks for being awesome little brothers. Samuel, I know you're giving me a hard time about going to Purdue. He is a huge IU fan. He'll learn. Maybe over the next 4 years, I can convince you that Purdue is a better school. I want to thank my grandparents, my Nana Flynn and Nana Foster, who were always so kind and supportive of me. I want to thank my grandfather for all the time you took out by myself and me, made me feel special. I love being your Saturday morning donut buddy, where we talk about, you know, Thomas the Train and music to the meaning of life. I want to thank my mom for giving me the compassion in my heart and hearing me out on whatever stupid stuff I had to say. And then lastly, I want to thank my dad for teaching me to be strong. The things you do and overcome make me feel like I can do anything. You have done so much for this family and community, giving me these good looks. But I am honored to have your middle name and be named after you, knowing all the amazing things you have done. So next year, I will attend Purdue University, so I felt it was fitting to leave the EDS class of 2024 with two quotes from Purdue University alumni Neil Armstrong. Shoot for the stars, but if you happen to miss, shoot for the moon instead. And lastly, he also said, I believe every human has a finite number of heartbeats, and I don't intend to waste any of mine. Class of 2024, congrats. And go out there. Don't waste any heartbeats. Thank you, and God bless.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Phil. And first, I wanted to start by thanking my parents. Mom and Dad, you brought me so far, and I wouldn't be here without your endless support. You drove me to school for 8 years, since I only got my license last year. And you were always there for me, all the way from second grade up until now, and in the future, and everything in between. And next, I want to thank my sister Valerie, because you've always been there to help me with my homework, especially with assignments that need art skills. Like that postcard from my AP Lang class, that was all her. I think how my art skills have improved significantly from that time I drew that one terrible drawing of my dad for his birthday card. It was pretty bad. But you're the artist in our family. I'll miss seeing your amazing art posted on the wall near Mr. Bosler's room. Now to Nate. Sophomore year, you didn't ask me to join the soccer team. You said I was in it. After our first practice with Mr. Dragon, I went that same day and bought all the gear. I bought cleats, socks, shin guards, and a bag. And the team environment was so welcoming that I wanted to be a part of it the moment I stepped on the field. And I'll also miss hardly working together during our last period study hall after working hard in the classes before. Jesse, you're a great friend, and I enjoyed not only seeing you in my classes, but also on the soccer field. You always help me focus on completing something once we start it, even if it's right before the deadline, like when we need to paint our senior parking spots black, or after doing our podcast project for Ms. Gelhausen 2 hours before prom. You're a great leader on the field after school and personally helped me achieve my potential as a soccer player. And also, don't forget to tell me when you get the parts for your computer so we can build it together and play R6. To Tyler, you're the coolest person that I've interned for. You taught me a lot about technology, and one thing I quickly learned is that you should not trust primary schoolers to remember their passwords, because you're going to be resetting them every week. And thanks to you and the school, I was the first student to achieve a IT certificate, and I was able to take the Azure Fundamentals exam and pass it. To Ms. Galhausen, I don't think I'd be accepted into Purdue without making sure I filled out my application. And I also enjoyed volunteering with the Tales on Trails group, so thank you for setting up that with the NHS. And you made sure each and every one of us had our opportunities to soar as day school eagles. Mr. O, you showed me how interesting Shakespeare can be, despite me thinking it was boring initially. I had you as my humanities teacher freshman year and again for my senior year. And to quote from Hamlet, my necessaries are embarked, farewell. Your class started and ended my high school journey, and for that I'm grateful. Mr. Ward, getting up early on a Saturday for math academic bowl practice is not easy, but the food you prepared made it slightly more bearable. Your methodical approach to teaching math, even when going off on tangents, showed me how you actually care about what you teach. To Ms. Moran, even though I only had a few classes with you, your careful approach to science, especially with AP Bio, set me up for future success in computer science. And I'm also thankful for the time that, despite you having a one-day notice, you wrote me a letter of recommendation so that I could finish my MIT application. And even though I didn't get accepted, that showed me that you care about your students. So thank you for that. And finally, to my classmates that are going to be my former classmates, thank you. Even though our schedules never lined up, I enjoyed our classes together, especially English. Everyone here has made my time one of a kind, and I wouldn't have wanted it any other way.
The first people that I want to thank are Ms. Gelhausen and Ms. Zimmer, because both of them had me in class this year. And I understand that they were probably scared about giving me a microphone in front of a bunch of people because they probably didn't think that I was ever going to sit down. Now I'd like to confirm those suspicions by asking someone for the Knicks score. We're in the middle of game 6 right now, so if someone could cue that up, that'd be great. Come on. Okay. All right. I gotta be serious. As most of you can either remember or imagine, there's a multitude of emotions associated with graduating high school. In the interest of time, I chose only to express one tonight. This choice came to me because of a journal prompt in Ms. Gelhausen's AP Lit class on whether or not money can buy happiness. It was during our Great Gatsby unit. It was actually Coltrane who spoke about how happiness can only be obtained from money if someone is grateful for what they have. The idea that the emotional value of an experience is unlocked through gratitude seems to apply universally, and it certainly applies to my experience at day school. The first group of people that I'm really thankful for is my family, and first and foremost, my mom. She's taught me to live my life as an artist and to explore life rather than just live my life. Next, I'm very grateful for my grandma and grandpa who are here today. They are possibly the only two people in my life who have never told me to stop talking, and it's very comforting when I go over to their house, along with a game of hearts. My two brothers are here, and I want to give them credit. I have an older brother who never fails to set the bar high, and a younger brother who never fails to surpass the bars I set. This combination has been the strongest motivational force in my life, and I'm forever grateful for it. Before I move on to the people that I'm thankful for that aren't my family, there's one person that kind of sits in a gray area, and for me, that's Nate Phillips. Nate's... You're not the dude I thought I was going to cry on, bro. Nate's a really good guy. I met him when I shadowed in sixth grade, and we got to be on the same PE team together because he convinced Mr. Dragon that I was emotionally distraught and would only be comfortable with him if we played together. We dominated and were never allowed to be on the same PE team again. But we were fortunate enough to play quite a few sports together, especially soccer, taking home two co-MVPs, junior and senior year. He truly is my other half in the sense that whatever it is, me and Nate either do it exactly the same or exactly opposite. People joked that we were going to give our speech together, but I guess back-to-back is just going to have to do. Next, I want to speak about the people that really define my 4 years in high school. First, it's all my classmates, who I'm eternally grateful for, and in particular, those who I was both classmates and teammates with. Rosie, Trista, Phil, Kane, Austin, and Nate. You guys inspire and motivate me, and the memories that I made with you will continue to do so throughout my life. My athletic journey at EDS is something I'll never forget, and it was made possible by people like Coach Wilsey, Coach Dragon, and also Coach Ryswick, who I have to give a special shout out to for making my last athletic season a lot more fun than I thought it was going to be. I've also had an enriching academic experience at EDS. Mr. Almohandro was my teacher, advisor, and speech coach at different points throughout my high school career, and the best way that I can describe the lasting effect he's had on me is that he has left me with a passion for words that I'm eternally grateful for. I want to express my gratitude for Mr. Bosler, who deservedly so won an award tonight, and Ms. D'Alto, who accompanied me on the guitar. Together, their classes have helped me grow and become more comfortable as an artist. They are two of the most talented artists, but also teachers and communicators that I've ever been around. The last person I want everyone to know that I'm grateful for is my dad. I stray away from in-depth conversations about my dad in the school setting. I'm often talking to students of his or people who work for him, so it can be a little awkward. I felt like this was the one moment where it was okay. Earlier I mentioned how my brothers motivate me, but the truth is we're all in a lifelong race to be like my dad. As a father, he's empathetic and resourceful. As a teacher, he's consistent and caring. As a leader, he's smart and committed. He's my role model. So much so that oftentimes when people compliment me on something, I'm thanking him inside my head by way of the transitive property because it's something that he taught me. I'm grateful to have my dad in my life around the clock at school and at home. The lessons he has given me in and outside of the classroom will stay with me forever. Finally, I'm forever grateful to the entire EDS community for how they have helped me make such a great experience out of my time. I hope that my words can inspire younger kids to take advantage of every opportunity that they get at this special school because there are good people in the room no matter what door you go through at EDS. Thank you.
Hello everyone, there's a lot of familiar faces here. That doesn't really help the fact that I'm still pretty nervous to be up here. I'm gonna try to keep this short and sweet, but I'm gonna do my best not to cry, no promises. You know, it's kind of crazy being in school for as long as I have. This makes me feel a little bit old, so I can't imagine how my lower school teachers sitting over there feel, especially my mom. I've made a lot of memories at the school, memories that will last a lifetime. Like the time I ate somebody's art project in lower school. It's a long story, but it happened. Or all those long speeches that Mr. Dragon gave, when none of us really cared, but we just kind of wanted to play the games, but sometimes we didn't get a chance to do that. Or all those nature walks that we went on with Pal. That's just the beginning of a long list, But I feel like I got to relive many of these memories this year when we got the privilege to have prom on the playground. No, but seriously, there's a lot of things I'm going to miss about the school. I'm definitely going to miss the teachers. Those ones sitting over there. Mr. O's trying to act too cool for school, but I could go down the list and talk about all the teachers and how they've impacted me, but we'd be up here for a while and you guys would be bored. Instead, I just want to say thank you all for putting up for me for the last 14 years. Next, I want to thank my family sitting over there. You guys have put up with me for the last 18 years. I want to thank the McCandlesses for welcoming me, and especially Matt for helping me and supporting me in ways that you don't understand. I really appreciate you. Next, I want to say thank you to Megan. Everyone knows you're my girlfriend, but you're also my best friend. You have pushed me to be better, and I am very appreciative for that. We made it through senior year together. At times, I didn't know if we would, but we did it. I'm very excited for IU next year. Go Hoosiers. I love and appreciate everything that you and your family have done for me, and you guys really make me feel like a part of the family. All right, Mom. It's your turn. I've been thinking about what I was going to say to you in my senior speech for really ever since Drew gave his speech. I wrote here, it probably won't matter because I'm just going to cry, but I'll do my best. Those of you know my mom, you know how awesome she is. I actually want to congratulate her on becoming the new head of primary school, so a round of applause. I'm very proud of you, and you're going to need something to keep you busy while I'm gone. I'm going to miss you, seeing you march through the halls on your daily power walks. Even though you always tried to embarrass me by doing some goofy wave or whatever you would do, but really, you kind of just embarrass yourself more. I credit you for making me the person I am today. You know, whether that be a good thing or a bad thing, I'll let you guys decide. But seriously, thank you for always being there for me and always staying strong in the hardest times. You have no idea how much it's meant to me, and I love you. And lastly, I want to say thank you to day school as a whole. It's been real. Thank you.
When I was a freshman, I watched my older sister, Cece, graduate from Evansville Day School, and I cried throughout her entire speech. I was so sad knowing that we wouldn't be making memories in the same building anymore. From that point on, I made an effort to cherish every moment at the school so I would feel no regrets when closing my chapter as an Eagle on this stage. I thought I had so much time to prepare what I'd want to say in this moment and know exactly how I would feel as a graduate. But I don't. Specifically this year, I've made a point of making every milestone as a senior sentimental, even if those milestones seemed insignificant to most. I watched the year fly by and last. My last first day of school at EDS, my last picture day, my last cross-country meets, my last cheer practices, my last high school English classes, and as of recently, my last days in the building. However, when reflecting on how I feel tonight as a soon-to-be EDS graduate, I don't feel sad and mournful of all of my lasts, but rather I feel so incredibly grateful. Change can be scary, but rather than counting down the moments in fearful anticipation of change, tonight I feel so lucky to have crossed paths with the people that have truly made my years at EDS memorable. So here are a few shout outs to those people. Ms. Jennings, you are one of my greatest role models and I could talk to you for hours. Ms. Brooks, thank you for always believing in me and for supporting me in starting running club. Mr. O, you are the only one that can make a class about Shakespeare the highlight of Senior's Day. Ms. Gelhausen, thank you for making our class feel so seen and loved. To all my coaches, thank you for pushing me to be my best and helping me to find my passions. To Nate, it has been a joy to spend these past 4 years with you, and you have no idea how proud I am of you. To my classmates, you have become family to me, and I have loved watching you all grow as people. Although my chapter in the building and as a high school student and athlete may be coming to an end, the impact these people have had on me will be something that I'll cherish forever. The people that Day School has connected me with have encouraged me to find my voice, lead fearlessly, and find comfort in new experiences. I have also received so much love and support from my family that has made me the person I am today. My oldest sister, Katie, never missed a chance to commute from wherever she was working to watch me run, celebrate my birthday with me, or come to a basketball game. She is so selfless and always goes above and beyond for me. Cece brings so much joy into my life, and she'll always be my partner in crime, even if we're going to rival schools next year. My sisters have been my closest companions and best friends, and they inspire me every day. My grandparents are here tonight, and I am so thankful to be their granddaughter. Even from 700 miles away, they've supported me in all my endeavors and have shown me so much love. The people who deserve the biggest shout out are my parents. I'm thankful every day that they gave me the opportunity to attend this school. After my eighth grade basketball season, which Trista has already brought up, a few girls behind me remember this all too well because we went 0-13. I never thought my dad would coach me again. Yet, this past year, he's been my track and cross country coaches, and I'm fully aware I'm not the easiest athlete to coach at times. But my whole life, my dad has truly been the best coach and father I could ever ask for. He supported me in every dream that I've ever had and has never allowed me to give up on myself. My mom deserves many thank yous for making sure I have everything I need to succeed in life, constantly taking pictures of our greatest sporting events, and giving me the best advice throughout high school. My mom is everything I hope to be one day. Thank you, Mom and Dad, and I don't know what you guys will do without me next year. My high school experience has been filled with trying new things and working hard to achieve my goals. I'm so proud to have been an Eagle, and I'm filled with endless gratitude and excitement as I begin this next chapter of my life. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm just going to jump right into my speech. My whole life, I've loved the arts. As a little girl, I've always been drawing or singing constantly to the point where my bedroom was lined with my drawings. Most of my favorite memories are in art classrooms with my friends, and I remember being so excited to run home to show my mom my art. There's videos of me singing about how I love fairies to my parents in their bedroom, and little me would gather my family in the living room and blast Firework by Katy Perry on my CD. Constantly making up my own choreography as I sang it to them. I'd be running to show them my choreography, my dance songs, or the art I'd made them. As a military kid, I've been through 10 different schools, at minimum, and that was challenging. But this is because of my parents' support of my creativity that has helped me through each transition. In each new school, I would find my creative outlet that would help me grow. Throughout middle school, I saw my big sister, Julia, perform in color guard. And I saw her excel, and I decided I wanted to follow in her footsteps. The team called me Little Sat, and the color guard community took me in. In eighth grade, when I could perform during indoor season, they made me feel welcomed and introduced me to the feeling of being on stage. It was scary and daunting, and the whole team of older girls cheered me on, coaching me and supporting me, and most importantly, I had my sister's guidance. In my freshman year, I finally got to perform along my big brother in our school's marching band during our outdoor season. I looked up to Connor for what to do and how to interact with people on the long days where all I wanted to do was go rest at home. Throughout high school, he became my best friend, and he moved away to college 3 years ago, but he still commits time to me. The distance has only strengthened our connection, and Connor's somebody I call when I need advice, a person to yap to, or really just a really, really good laugh. He's my role model, and I wouldn't be who I am today without him. In the most recent years, I've dedicated my time to theater. I've moved here 3 years ago, and Miss Ferguson needed me to do the spotlight, so I volunteered myself. And I loved it. The ability to watch the show and bring light, literally, to the show was amazing. I was terrified of the change when she left, but Miss Dialto has advocated for a better program. And for the last 2 years, she's been my mentor. During our independent study, she's helped me grow our program exponentially, which in turn grew my abilities. I went from a small spotlight to a whole lighting system at New Harmony, and Ms. Dialto pushed for me to go outside of day school and help the Children's Theater and AVSC's summer musical, which has me actively branching out in the theater community. She's given me the little push for theater I didn't know I needed. My love for theater went from a spark to a dream to executing a plan of how I can stay in my life. Not I, theater. And while doing the lights has been one of my favorite things in high school, my true favorite thing has been getting to watch my little sister, Eden, grow up. Over the last 5 years, I've watched my siblings leave for college, but Eden's always been there, driving her to school every day for the past semester. Has given us a better bond and quality time that I couldn't have expected, and I'm not sure what I'll do without her company. She's one of my best friends and somebody I confide in, and I'm so lucky to have the connection I do with her. These past few weeks, that's all I've thought about is my siblings and just how special it is to be in the same school, which each of them at least once. I'm gonna miss her so much, and I'm not sure what I'll do with myself. She's been a constant in my life, and I couldn't be more lucky to watch her shine on stage and grow older. I hope the arts are something that stays with me forever, connecting me with the people I love. Thank you to my parents for constantly encouraging me, supporting me, and loving me through it all. I wouldn't be where I am today without your unwavering support. Thank you to my mom for handing your creativity off to me and giving me confidence to try new things and for always being up to go out in the world. Thank you to my dad for giving me so many opportunities and making me laugh when I'm feeling blue and dedicating your time to bettering our lives. Again, thank you for everything.
How's it going? All right. First off, I would like to thank Evansville Day School as a whole for giving me the opportunity to achieve and conquer different accomplishments, feats, goals, whether they be athletically or academically. Truthfully, when I first found out I was moving to day school, I wasn't excited. I was moving away from my friends. I was just annoyed. But the thing about my parents, they are super good at moving from place to place. So good, in fact, they're doing it again, for anyone who doesn't know. My dad got a coaching job, so good job, Dad. Hold on. Oh, I also like to thank my parents for motivating me in the classroom. I didn't always follow through on my end of the bargain, but I'm up on the stage, so I'll take that. I was able to play 4 years of varsity basketball for my dad. That was always interesting because Nate and Jesse can attest to this. My dad yaps a lot about people that I've met like once or twice, but he thinks that I know them, so I'm just like nodding my head along. I know him, I don't. I even played soccer for 2 years, even though pretty much my entire life I bashed soccer, saying it was very boring. It's not boring, it's actually kind of fun. And then somehow, some way, Megan convinced me to do track this year. I know I have one, at least for sure, one coach in here. That probably wasn't my smartest decision I've ever made here. That was not fun, but but I appreciate it. It was, okay. Also, I think Mr. O, we would always talk in study hall. He's such a dynamic guy, you know, you could talk to him about sports, music, Shakespeare, but that was more like he was glue and I was rubber, and then it was just back and forth with himself. I didn't really know what it was about because I don't understand Shakespeare. But he's quirky, he's kind of funny, a little weird, a good weird. But he's a cool guy. Also, Miss Gelhausen probably helped me a lot getting into college, so I appreciate that very much. I remember just recently she came up to me worried about my FAFSA form. And I was like, no, I got it. I didn't do it. You can blame my mom for that one. Yeah. To end on a quote, it's a personal quote, I like it. You can't control the wind, but you can adjust your sails. Thank you.
Hello. Before I begin, I want to give a quick disclaimer. I cry a lot and at everything, and I want to apologize to all of the teachers that I have made extremely uncomfortable for the amount of times that I have cried in your classes. I'm looking at Mr. Bossler because one day I cried because I couldn't mix paint, and I didn't work the rest of the class. So we're going to get through it together with as many tears as it will take. When I began writing this, I had no idea what to put in my speech. I have so many wonderful memories of day school, and I found it difficult to choose just one that defined my time here. A lot has changed for me since starting day school. I was an extremely shy seventh grader who didn't know where she belonged. I thought that I wouldn't have a place in my class, but they welcomed me with open arms. I went from barely speaking in class to enjoying the conversations I had with my friends and my teachers. I joined the speech team, academic bowl, and cheer. I found my love for community service. I have found people that I am honored to call my friends because I know they will always have my back. Even when things were hard and I felt defeated, there was always someone there for me no matter what. I am so lucky to have so many people in my corner pushing me to success. Every little moment I've had at day school has made me the way that I am. I am blessed with lifelong friendships with my class, as well as mentors that I can look towards. I have grown and changed over these past 6 years. I've become more confident, a better student, and a better person. Day school has fostered my love for education and has prepared me for the rest of my life. And I know that I would not be where I am today without Evansville Day School, and I am eternally grateful for all that you have done for me.
If I had the words and time to thank everybody individually who I want to thank, we would be here for the next 3 graduations and I still wouldn't be halfway through. So for the sake of everyone's time and my own tears, I'm gonna jump into this. I've been going to EES for a decade of my life. My time here, there have been friendships, pandemic, isolation, heartbreak, and family. I'd first like to thank my left hallway friends, Alexa, Iggy, Greta, Luther, Bree. I'm sorry for making you cry. I know y'all are gonna cry. But these are the people who I've been spending my lunches with for the past two years. You all have such unique ways of living and have just impacted me so much. I think this is one of the best big friend groups that I've had just in my entire life, and I thank y'all for that. There hasn't been a dull lunchtime with you guys around, and truly, I hope that I can stay in touch with as much of you as I can, even if some of y'all are kind of shut-ins, but I'll still remember all the times that I've spent with you guys. Next, I'd like to thank my senior class. You've come and gone with the years. People have left, people have came here, but we've all grown together and formed memories with each other. We've had moments in our lives I will never forget, whether it be for humor, mostly for humor. And yeah, I also want to thank my teachers. These are some of the kindest and nicest teachers that probably exist on this entire planet. They've shown me all that I'm capable of. I thank them for that. Lastly, I want to thank my family. Mom, Dad, you've always been there for me. and have done everything you can to make sure that I have a good life. And you've done a lot. And you know that I wouldn't be here today with as much confidence speaking, or even speaking for that matter, without you guys. Well, my brother, I don't even know if you're in this auditorium right now, but I know you're proud of me. You taught me a lot of things about life. And you've always cared about me. I'll try to keep contact with you during college, when you pick up the phone, because now you're busy. And because they're also here, I also want to thank my grandparents. I've never met such cool and interesting grandparents in my entire life. And every day that I see them, they are the highlight of my day because of just how just amazing they are and how much happiness they can bring into a room. And I hope that I carry that with me for the rest of my life, and that's something that I learned from them. And for everyone else in this auditorium who I haven't thanked in this speech, thank you.
At this time, we'd like to present diplomas to the class of 2024. Rosemary Margaret Alcock. Austin William Boyle. Katrina Rose Braun. Trista Madison Browning. Philip Daniel Kulikoff. Jesse Thomas Kunst. Thank you. Richard Nathan Phillips. Megan Elizabeth Reiswick. Elena Marie Statt. Kane G. Wilsey. Madison Leslie Windner. Maren R. Woosley. Families and friends, EDS students, faculty, staff, thank you for being with us here tonight and for sharing this evening. Families, I'm especially grateful for you for the gift of trust that you place in us, the gift of these beautiful young people that we are fortunate to be able to spend time and grow with. They've left a legacy that will not soon be forgotten. I also want to take a moment to recognize a few people, one of whom who is not here, Tom Dragon, had 30 years of service to Evansville Day School, and many of you sitting behind me tonight were very important people to Mr. Dragon, and we all are very fortunate to have had him at our school. Robin Rentschler, who is our primary school head, after 17 years is saying goodbye to us, and we are very fortunate to have had her in our service. And then Mr. Kunst, Kevin Kunst, this is his last graduation? 37 graduations? Yeah, his 37th graduation. So thank you to those dedicated members of our EDS. Graduates, I also want to thank you. It has been my absolute pleasure to be able to serve you these last 4 years. I've had many of you in class, and I have learned as much from you as I hope that you have taken away from the classes you've been in at school. I will miss you dearly, and I hope that you come see us very often. All right. So, at this time, I'd like to ask the class of 2024 to please rise. And I will now ask that you change your tassels. Join me in congratulating the class of 2024.